I'm Susie Roberti, and welcome to Let's Talk Tailwaggers. We have Susie Smith here today, and we have a surprise guest. Very interesting show, and I know that you're going to learn so very much about organizations, and this series of shows that I have been doing is all about the organizations and how they're helping the animals. So before I get started, I would like to say thank you to both of my cameramen. And you know that BPTV is all volunteers, and you are more than welcome to come up and learn how to use cameras, which is a very nice thing. Or you could do a show, or you could help Dave in the office, or just even go out and shoot with us. You're more than welcome to visit. So now we're going to get started with Susie Smith.
Hi, Susie. Thanks for having me on the show again, as usual.
Yes, and mm-hmm. I have a frog in my throat today. We're Pets for Vets.
I'm the organizer and coordinator of the Pets for U.S. Vets through 84 Fitness Center, and our function benefits the Veterans Fund we had set up 2 years ago. And our local veterans don't have to pay adoption fees at the Washington Humane
that
Society
is
anymore.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. The best. And your name is?
Andrew Volchko. I'm with the Western Pennsylvania Police Benevolent Foundation and also a proud police officer here in Bethel Park.
I told you we had a surprise guest. Now, what's your organization all about?
We started about a year ago to help injured police officers. Along with their families, fallen officers, injured officers, disabled, and their families. There's so much going on when you're dealing with that,
yeah.
That you need a support system, not just for the monetary side, but sometimes just somebody to talk to, somebody to be with your family when there's surgeries.
You know, I think people truly forget about that, you know, that there is surgeries, you know, and there's time losing work and being frightened and upset, and it's really nice that people are starting to understand that there's more to someone getting shot. You know, it's very very devastating for the whole circle.
It's very tough, and the group of us that founded this, actually most of us have been injured, including myself. I spent 31 months off of the job injured. So
wow,
you know firsthand wow. When you're, you know, it's you, just you and your spouse and your kids, and you know, you're kind of
people
fighting that battle.
Me.
So there's so many little things from just, you know, just having somebody that understands or
aww.
That you can talk to, including these guys.
Oh, well, these guys, you got to admit.
They're the most important.
If you got a secret, you can tell them, and they'll never tell the secret.
Yeah, I just hope they can't ever tell, because the one that was with me when I got injured, he's got all the inside scoop.
Well, we had a little dog, Manchester Terrier when I was a teenager, and my mother, that dog was like a human being, because the teenage kids, you know, we were home torturing them and playing with them, but, you know, and my mother would be out in the kitchen, and she'd say, when you start talking, you're going.
All the secrets will
yeah,
be out.
Cause yeah, he just knew everything about everybody. It was mm-hmm. it was such a comic.
Well, you know what's funny? We have a parrot. And he talks, so you really have to be careful.
Oh, well,
that
yeah.
could be bad.
Yeah.
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 Now, what do you do? I mean, what is when you have your party, what mm-hmm. do you, what is it?
This specific one is the Paws for the Cause. We started it last year after Officer Kuzak was shot in Clareton, and his two dogs he was training as work dogs aww. Became his therapy and service dogs. So me wow. being a huge wow. dog lover, and Jimmy and I being friends for a long time, I said, hey, why don't we do something that involves the dogs? I had another friend who had an autism service dog, and I had known nothing about them. Through my friend getting one for their son, mm-hmm. I got very interested in that. And I said, man, there's so many different things these dogs do that, you know, if people don't know, they can't take advantage of it.
Well, the autism is truly a miracle
oh.
for the children, or I would imagine an adult. That is just new. You know, they're really studying and really getting into that, you know, for the children. It really, when I was younger, the vet said that I adored him. He has since passed away. But he always said about babies, you know, that slow to walk or they were slow to do things. He said, well, you get a puppy, and he put it on the floor, and it'll lick its in the baby's face, and then the baby wants to go, you know. So that was really exercise.
It stimulates them the
same
thing.
Yeah, exactly.
That was probably the beginning where they started realizing that animals could be used for autistic
children. Because that just, I get the goosebumps.
That's a truly incredible one to watch. I've watched my friend's son, Matt, just completely open up, you know, from the first few years to now. And it's those types of connections that have come fruitful for us in, in being able to help, you know, help other families.
Sure. And Susie's Pets for Vets, getting that they can get their animal for free,
definitely.
Then they have so much heartache inside. I have three older brothers and they were all in the service. I couldn't even imagine what's inside a man. You know, when you come home.
Oh,
you know,
I can't. I've been there.
And
again, they tell
you're
all
a veteran
my secrets.
Too.
I am.
Oh,
United
yeah.
States Army.
Oh,
yeah,
great.
And you can tell them things, or just touching them just makes you just feel so needed, you know, and so loved. And I really believe Susie's organization is really, you know,
well,
going to work on.
You know, sometimes I'm on the computer, and you probably are too. Like, and I'm not that good at the computer. I get the job done, but it's a struggle. And I'm on for 3 and 4 hours a day just banging away, trying to get the word out about respecting our veterans and helping our homeless animals. Well, just when I thought, well, is anybody really listening? I got a letter the other day from a Marine veteran that has post-traumatic stress syndrome, and he just lost his dog through cancer. And he wrote to me that he saw our ad on Craigslist. We're everywhere. We're just trying to get the word out. And he said he's just devastated. He has a hole in his heart. His soul is, you know, has been ripped open. He loved this dog, and you know, he's suffering from stress anyway from just getting home from the war.
Mm-hmm.
And he's told me about a dog that he was interested in, that he saw a picture at the Washington Area Humane Society. And her name was Sheba, and she was a big like a Eskimo Spitz Sammy mix. And so he said he was going to head down there and look at her. Well, it turned out when he got there, and this was the nicest letter, I'll bring it on the next show and read it, but he went down, and Sheba wasn't there. She was out on tour because she was the dog of the week, and so she had to make her rounds. Well, it turned out Sheba was the angel that led him to the Humane Society, and he fell in love with this little dog, Molly. And he wrote me a letter.
Yeah, I just read the article online. The letter was posted.
Did you see the letter?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah. And he just, his 8 and 10 year old sons are in love with the dog. And the dog, they've saved each other. And that's what the whole thing is about.
Yeah.
We're saving each other.
Yeah,
we're saving.
And that's what your organization is doing too. And everyone could please just truly from the bottom of my heart understand how important these guys are. They really and truly are. And the more money that we can have and get them to people, you know, it's wonderful. It's just a wonderful thing. Now, where is your dog party?
This year's PAWS event is going to be at the, used to be the Charles E. Kelly Support Facility. It was the Army Reserve Base that was in Oakdale, Collier Township.
Yeah.
It's now turned over to the Township of Collier to become a big park.
Oh.
So the one portion of that park we're going to have for August 25th, everything will be there. It includes, we do a nature walk with them to start the day. And then we come back and we have demonstrations from, you're going to have police dogs, work dogs, therapy dogs, service dogs, autism dogs, the bed bug dog, the mold dog.
Oh, the bed bug.
If it's got four or even three legs and it does something, they'll be there. Plus, it's everybody's pets. So you get to be out. And what's truly amazing is I'm a huge advocate with the bully breeds because I kind of associate the same thing. You see something big, you get afraid of it. Well, that's not necessarily the right way to be.
Yeah.
So last year, we had every breed that's ever been talked bad about there by the hundreds, and not one pip, not one, you know, one thing. We had pools, they could swim, and they were laying in the fields, and it was a beautiful, truly beautiful thing to see all the pits, rots, shepherds,
like
mountain
heaven.
I mean, everything you can think of.
Well,
there.
I think it's because everybody was an owner, you know, and it was relaxed because everybody was an owner, and they understand that. They truly do.
Oh,
animals do.
Definitely.
I've done shows for when they bless the pets, mm-hmm. you know. And I'll go in this big field, you know, and barking, meow, 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 and everything. And soon as the priest or minister starts to talk, everybody lays down. It's scary. The dogs and cats quiet.
They understand.
And they they just know.
It is amazing to watch, because we had, like I said, as everybody's coming out there and the dogs are running around, they're playing, and, you know, it's a huge field. We did it in Peterswood Park last year. And we had the amphitheater and everything, and there's just people everywhere, and the barbecue guy's making food, and there's no issues there, and it's just, it's truly nice to watch, because then people who, you know, maybe weren't a fan of those breeds gets to see that, you know, it's not the dog, it's the owner that's the problem.
Yeah.
You know, I got 100 plus pounds of muscle sitting here in front of me.
And he's a joy, you know, well, and I've always been afraid of Rottweilers, always, because in the movies, you know, they're always so mean.
The media does so much damage.
Yeah, they do.
That's why I love your show, because it's always good news. We always have good news to say. It's nothing bad.
It's always because they're special. And they do. Mm. They do bring so much into your heart.
Oh, they're, like I said, I people, you know, they talk, and it's not just my dogs, but my animals in general. This type of job, you got a lot of stress, things going on. So I go home to, you know, I have 4 dogs there.
Aww.
I have 2 horses at another location, and that's therapy. You know, people mm-hmm. say that's a lot of work. Well, no, it's not really, because you go and they don't complain. They don't.
I think it's a work if you don't like animals. But if you truly are in heart with them, it's like changing a diaper on a baby. You know, that's your child, and you change the diaper, and you do this, you do that for them. And it isn't work. It's joy, you know.
Yeah, these guys are, you know, like I said, I come home at 7 this morning from working. And they're all there, like, come on, let's go. You know?
They're like sponges. They kind of pull, like, all of the anxiety out of you. Yeah. I have 4 dogs, too. We have 4 rescued hound dogs. And we have had the bully breeds before. We had a 105-pound beagle pit bull. And
that's an odd mix.
It was a real odd mix. But we would just tell people he was a beagle on steroids. People would back up when they'd see him. But he looked like a hound dog, but his chest was like 40 inches around. He was just huge. And the sweetest thing, just like your handcuffs here, he was just a big kisser, and you love them, and they're going to be good.
And they look you with their eyes. Mm-hmm. I don't care what.
Especially those big, big browns. Yeah.
He doesn't like them or anything.
Do you know the most discriminated dog in the shelter is a big black dog?
Yeah, people are just intimidated by their sight, and they just...
Big black
associate.
Dog.
Oh, I did not know that.
They don't get adopted very very often.
You know, I never even gave that a thought.
Yeah, in the scheme of things. And so black dogs, when I was volunteering a lot at the shelter, would always pull the black dogs out and try to showcase them, because mm-hmm. I knew the little white dogs and the little hounds were going to get adopted, but not the big black ones.
Now, what time is the paws going to start?
It starts, the registration will be there earlier, but around 8:30 or so the registration will start, gets people signed in for a $15 donation, which goes directly to the foundation. They'll get a t-shirt similar to the one I'm wearing today, the Paws for the Cause. The dogs aren't left out. They get a bandana with the same logo on, which is cute to see 200 dogs walking with their bandanas on.
Oh, my Lord.
And then they're eligible for it. We'll have vendors. We have a couple co-sponsors. Hello Bully and Animal Friends are the 2 biggest. And Pet Supplies Plus here in Bethel.
Wow.
Petco here. And the one in Robinson, Pet Supplies Plus, provide treats, toys, goodie bag for every dog that registers to come in.
Wow.
And then there are demonstrations all day long. We'll have on the flyer, they can go onto our website. It's www.wppbf.org. Click to the upcoming events. You'll see a flyer that has the pictures of Shorty Rossi, who's our guest star that comes in every year now to help us from the Pit Boss Show on Animal Planet.
That's
He'll be there, and he does speeches about the breed-specific legislation, his fighting against that. And then we have just demonstrations throughout the afternoon.
And I think that would really be wonderful for people to see, you know, because you do learn a lot about training your animal, but joining with it.
Oh yeah,
you know that.
And we'll have there'll be a ton of different Maloney's Canine Academy came last year.
Wow.
The CGC program, or Canine Good Citizen. People are there. Therapy Dogs United participates, and
wow.
So you have demonstrations from all these groups, plus the different trainers who are giving you ideas and
mm-hmm.
you know can help you. And a lot of times they did spot checks. If they walked around and saw something, they'll take the time to stop and say, "Hey, let me show you a couple things just real quick." You know, little things. And
So that's really educational,
yeah.
And you can.
Yeah.
That's the whole day is
points.
About educating,
mm-hmm.
but having a good time.
Yeah.
You know, for a good cause while you're there, getting out with the dogs, and there's not a lot of outdoor events for the dogs anymore. I mean, people are worried about rain delays and everything else, mm-hmm. so they do, you know, indoors. A lot of people really look forward to having an outdoor one where you got to be out and walk in the sun and enjoy the day.
And
even if
the
weather happens, you know,
it
we'll
happens.
Roll with it.
Yeah.
You know, we'll
it
do
happens.
It.
It happens.
We're not going to melt.
They won't mind. They'll be swimming mm-hmm. just the same. They won't
now,
have
you don't
problems.
Have to bring a dog.
No, you don't.
No,
you don't.
Just, okay.
Yeah, if you do and you want to do the walk, but there'll be people that will be from everywhere that'll come and join us.
Now, when I met Drew here at BPTV, we started talking, and it turns out he knew, part of this is for Dave's family. Dave Dreyer was a veterinarian and a police officer and an EMT and
a fireman.
Wow.
And a husband and a father and a good person. And I knew Dave from 84 Fitness Center. Officer Dave Dreyer was shot and killed about a year ago.
East Washington in December.
December?
I want to say around the 19th, if I recall, 16th mm-hmm. or 19th.
And it was funny because about 12 years ago, I met Dave at 84 Fitness Center because we worked out together and I'd see him in the mornings. I taught the 6:15 a.m. step class.
Oof.
And Dave was there working out. Well, one morning about 6:30, I just was in the middle of class. And a guy, somebody yelled into the aerobic room, a guy down in the sauna. Well, Buck was his name. Buck and Janie were always at the gym in the mornings. And Buck had just worked out. I saw him upstairs. Well, he collapsed in the sauna, had a heart attack. And I looked at Lynn, Lynn Osborne, who I always talk about because she's the one that is responsible for helping me with this Pets for U.S. Vets. She was working the front desk at the time. She wasn't manager yet. And I looked at her and she looked at me and we knew we had to do CPR. So I know I had a guardian angel that day because I did not want to do CPR. It scares me. I'll do it. I'm certified. But out of nowhere comes Dave Dreyer and another EMT, because he was an EMT from upstairs, came down. They worked on Buck, and Lynn and I were just, you know, we were there helping, but we didn't have to, you know.
Here comes my angel.
Here comes the angel. What would be the odds that two EMTs would be right there when we needed them? Well, Dave worked continuously. It took 20 minutes before the ambulance got there. I don't know why, but it took forever. And Dave and Bob, another EMT, worked continually on Buck. And then Buck, his heart started beating again. They took him away. And I wanted to mention this today because I've never had a chance to tell Dave's family about this. But I wanted them to know that he saved Buck's life. Well, Dave never got, and it was funny, Dave never knew that he saved Buck's life. He didn't know what happened to him mm-hmm. afterwards. And I just ran into Dave. You're saying he got shot in December.
Yeah.
I'm thinking it was August I saw Dave. It was right August. Might have been September. It was right before my dog party, and Dave donated a bunch of stuff to the Pets for U.S. Vets dog party. His groomer came, Tila came over, and we just, you know, it was a nice party, and Dave donated all kind of stuff. He gave me coupons for people to come in and get free checkups. And
he's a fantastic man.
Really good guy. Well, the weird thing was I hadn't seen Dave in all those years because, we'd miss each other. He'd be in and out of the gym or whatever. But I was able to tell him, I said, "Do you know what happened to Buck?" And he said, "I never heard." And I said, "You saved his life." And he said, "That's the only time that he was ever able to save somebody with CPR, because most of the time you don't. You know, by the time they're down, they're down."
Yeah.
But he thanked me for telling him. And I said, "Well, it's just an honor for me to, I didn't know that, you know, he didn't realize he saved that man's life."
Yeah.
But what are the chances I would have seen him a month before he got killed to be able to tell him that?
He actually his one of the logos you're going to see on the flyer is his veterinary clinic.
I see it right here at the top.
Yeah, if you notice the symbolism there, the cross made out of the two pictures is actually the logo, the sticker that was made for Dave when to raise money for Ben, his son, Ben. Yeah. And then the picture directly below that is actually Ben with his new autism service dog, Copper. The foundation, when right after this happened, that morning we were in East Washington, myself, I'm the secretary, and our president, we were there at like 7 in the morning.
Wow.
We immediately started mobilizing things to, to get things moving, but one of the things immediately at that point was knowing that his son Ben was autistic, and I knew the connections we had made last year from the Canines for Kids program that does the training. I said, it's a mission. I want to get this dog for him. So through a grant, we actually got the donation through DPS Penn to pay, covered all the training, everything. So we took him out about 2 months ago, and he picked, Ben kept telling us, I'm getting a black male. And he chose a sable-colored female shepherd. But the same day, within the first 20 minutes, she was at his feet, laying constantly. When he moved, she moved. Mm-hmm. So they're actually going to be there. It'll be a beautiful thing to see them, because you get to
see. I know Dave knows what you guys have done for him. I mean, it's just, I didn't know Dave that well. I just, we had crossed paths over the years, but I really respect what you're doing. And when I found out that you were friends with Dave Dreyer, I just thought this is just perfect, because this cause is really, it's in a way, it's similar, to what we're doing. We're helping.
You're helping in different areas.
Yeah,
and the more of us that link together, the more beneficial. I mean, that's the first thing we learned in this foundation is the network. Mm-hmm. The people that we've met over the year,
the network.
This past year, just like in this case, mm-hmm. I make one phone call. Hey, are you in? I'm in.
See?
And things happen.
Yeah.
Well, Susie's just starting out.
This is my third year.
And do you need volunteers?
Oh, yeah. I always need volunteers. I need, I brought my pamphlet today.
Hers is in October.
Mine's October 6th. And I'm always looking for vendors. And Drew said he would take some of my paperwork to the Paws for the Cause. Maybe I'll pull a few vendors from there.
Yeah.
I always need t-shirt sponsors. And mostly we need party animals, just people to come to the party. It's a very patriotic party. I can't say enough about the Claysville American Legion Riders. Those guys and gals, they come and they present the colors. So we start off with a total presentation of the colors, very patriotic. Then the Washington Festival Chorale has been invited back again this year to sing the national anthem. And we have the Young Marines, which is a fantastic organization. I come from a Marine family, so these guys just blow me away, these little kids that are so dedicated. And the Girl Scouts, they say the Pledge of Allegiance. And, we just have a great time, and then we kick it off with a walk through the ballpark, and we have food, and we have games, and Milkbone Toss, and just different goofy games to play.
Do you need any more vendors or anything?
I need vendors. People are starting to check in right now. I have that guy with the birds will always be there. He has dedicated his life to rescuing birds.
Can you believe that people are mean?
People,
to those big,
I don't know how you can do that.
You would not believe some of his stories. You have to watch Susie's show.
I've done shows with this man, and to hear that somebody got one of those big macaws, gorgeous thing, and put it in their living room. And he said, nobody understands. These birds scream. And he said, this travels like 10 miles in Africa or wherever they come from.
Yeah.
And he says, so the people would throw things at him and hurt him, And he said, then they got so angry, they took him down and put him in the garage under a table. And they would go down there and just feed him.
For years.
Well, for years. He picked every single feather off of his body.
That's Harley. That's his signature bird that you're talking about, Harley.
And, oh, God, it gives me the creeps.
But he's in full flight now.
There was a neighbor, I can't remember how he found out about it, but he goes everywhere getting these birds. And he went in and rescued him. He said it took him 2 years to get near that bird. But that's one of his best buds now.
Well, I'll tell you, one thing about that guy with the birds, his name is John Leegee.
His shows are tremendous.
He's a twice enlisted Vietnam veteran, and he totally supports our program because he realizes, and he is, for what he's been through, He's the kindest person. You see when he holds the little bird.
It's much like the abused animals.
Yeah.
Every animal in my home has been rescued, including ones that I've rescued here on the job, and they have every reason not to be happy, and they're the sweetest, most loving. Yeah. And it's the same thing. When you've seen the bottom of the barrel, it's a lot easier to want to be at the top.
I just had him out. That was that last Wednesday he came to Ben Franklin for the daycare kids. And it was only like 18 or 20 children there. And he was more than happy. And he sets up this most beautiful background, you know, with all these birches and all that kind of stuff. And at the end, and he walked around, and the kids never moved. And they were young. And at the end, each one came up, and he has this little parrot that he trained that turns upside down, lays on his back. It's a sweet thing. So they got to have that, and he put a little parakeet here, and another parrot. And each one of those kids got to stand there and get their picture taken with that.
And that's something they'll remember that for the rest of their life.
Yeah.
But it totally amazes you that anybody could be mean to a bird. Absolutely.
Well,
guess what?
Well, Is it time to go? It's always, but you know, Drew, seriously, when I met Drew, you can see he has a good aura.
Yes, he does.
See people's auras. And
yes.
You can tell he's an animal lover and a kind person.
Yes.
And I wish you all the best of luck with this Paws for the Cause. This is going to be great.
Thank you. I mean, like I said, it'll be a great day. And those who come out to see Shorty will have people there to take pictures to, and he'll be autographing his book.
And the date? And
August 25th.
August 25th.
And it's at the Nike site. It used to be the Charles E. Kelly Support Facility.
Okay.
If you put it in as the Army Reserve Base in Oakdale, it'll come up.
Okay.
Well, it's time to say goodbye.
Well, thank you.
Could I say
one more thing?
Yes.
You're always saying about, you know, how we do good things. The word wouldn't even get out there if it weren't for you.
Oh.
And asking us on here, seriously.
Networking. That's
networking.
All it's all about.
Yeah. So you really deserve a big attaboy today, because
you
really do a good job, Suze.
Thank you. I do it for you, not for me. I love you all. You know that. And please, that you've heard all the wonderful things that our dogs do. I call them guys. They're wonderful creatures. So please, Susie has hers. This young man's going to have his August the 25th. Please come and visit, and you will have a very good time. And like always, I want to thank you for all your support and your kindness. And most of all, I want to say thank you from all the tail waggers.